Hello everybody and welcome to my channel. In this video, we are going to talk about creating ribs and web features in Autodesk Inventor. Ribs and web features are normally used in plastic parts to prevent warping and add stiffness to the thin-walled parts. So the difference between web and rib is that web usually extrudes normal to the sketch plane and its thickness is parallel to the sketch plane, whereas rib usually extrudes parallel to the sketch plane and its thickness is normal to the sketch plane. So here we have a plastic part, and within this part is a work plane. Let's turn the visibility for the work plane on. There is a small diagonal line on this work plane, which will be used as the sketch for our rib feature. So let's activate the rib command, which is on the 3D model tab under the Create panel. And like every other command in Inventor, if we hover the mouse over the command, there will be some more information about the command and how it works. As soon as I select it, the rib dialog box will open and the only available sketch in the graphic area will be used for our rib feature. So the two buttons on the left side of the dialog box switch the type of the rib between web and rib, perpendicular to the sketch plane or parallel to the sketch plane. You can then use the direction buttons to make sure that the feature is going towards the right direction. Next, we have to choose the thickness of the rib. So let's change it to 3 mm, for example, to see how it works. As you can see, our rib is thicker now. But for this exercise, let's change it back to 1 mm again. The next option is the direction to which the thickness is applied, to the left of the sketch plane, to the right of the sketch plane, or the mid plane, which is what I'm choosing in here. And let's click OK to have our supporting rib created. Now let's take a closer look to the more advanced options we have in the rib dialog box. So on the bottom surface of this plastic part, I've created another sketch, as you can see. Let's select the rib command again and make sure that perpendicular or normal to the sketch plane is selected, and we are technically creating a web. Then click on the ellipse and each line one by one to select the whole profile and have a preview of what the web is gonna look like. If I switch the extend profile checkbox off, you can notice the difference in the preview. The ribs are not going to extend all the ways to the next surfaces. Here again I can choose the direction the thickness is applied, which I again leave it on the midplane. To explore the finite option, let's click on the finite button and type in, let's say, 3 mm. This will limit the depth of the rib to 3 mm rather than allowing them to extend all the way to the next surface. So I can change the depth of the rib to 1 mm, 2 mm, 3 millimeters, or all the way to the next surface. Alright, next, let's take a look at the draft tab. We have two options for holding the thickness, at top and at root. So if I select at top, the specified thickness will be held at top or at the sketch plane. Whereas at root holds the specified thickness at the intersection of the rib feature and the terminating face. And then we can set the draft angle to give our rib feature a variable thickness. And the last tab is boss tab. So bosses are protrusions that are used in plastic parts assembling. They are usually threaded and the screws are inserted into them to hold the assembly parts together. You can deselect the Select All checkbox and manually choose the location of the bosses to be added. Or you can select the Select All checkbox to make sure that all the center points in your sketch are selected. You can even hold the control button and click on each center point to deselect it and remove the boss added to that specific center point. And obviously we can control all the parameters like the draft angle, diameter and offset of the boss. Let's set the diameter to 4 millimeters, the offset to 3 millimeters, and finally the draft angle to 12 degrees. To complete the part, we can use commands like mirror to pattern, copy, multiply, and mirror the rib feature. Now if I make any change to the original feature, all the other copies of the feature will be updated as well. Thanks everybody for watching my video. My next Inventor training videos will be coming out very soon, so please don't forget to press the like button and subscribe. Thank you.